A few months ago, I posted a video that gave a bit of information on if a person with a uterus is able to get pregnant from pre-cum. And since then, my inbox has been overflowing. Tons of emails from you, tons of stories, a lot of them pretty explicit, with a lot of detail. And honestly, I don't have time to reply to all of them. So in this video, I'm gonna clarify what I said before and make sure that you have the right information so you know exactly how much risk you're engaging in. I'm Thomas, and I'm a sex researcher. Can you get pregnant from pre-cum? The short answer, no. But the longer answer, because biology and human function is complicated, is that, well, what you think pre-cum is may not actually be just pre-cum. When a person with a penis has an orgasm, a sticky white fluid comes out, which people often refer to as cum or think of as sperm. However, this fluid is technically called seminal fluid or semen and contains more than just sperm. Seminal fluid comes from four different places: the Cowper's gland, the seminal vesicle, the prostate, and the testes. During arousal, when the penis is erect, which yes, I realize it is not erect in this photo, but imagine it is, you pervert. Fluid is released from the Cowper's gland. The purpose of this fluid is to lube up the urethra of the penis so that when ejaculation occurs, the fluid is more easily able to exit. This fluid is also commonly referred to as pre-cum. Because this fluid comes from the Cowper's gland, there is no semen in it, at least not yet. Now, when someone with a penis orgasms, sperm is released from the testes. It goes through the epididymis, up the vas deferens, and continues forward. The seminal vesicle releases enzymes, acids, fructose, and essentially provides energy to the sperm to protect it from the immune response of the female's body. Basically, the female's body wants to destroy that foreign fluid. The prostate then releases more enzymes and vitamins that help to keep the sperm intact and mobile as it moves forward through the urethra and is expelled. Altogether, the sperm from the testes, fluid from the seminal vesicle, prostate, and Cowper's gland make up the seminal fluid or semen. This is the cum that you're used to hearing about, the sticky white stuff that can absolutely get someone with a uterus pregnant. After the person with the penis comes, it doesn't mean the system that the sperm traveled through is automatically empty and clean. Some could have been left behind, and it could still come out. If someone with a penis puts their penis back inside someone with a uterus right after they orgasm, more seminal fluid could be released and could cause pregnancy. Similarly, if you plan to go for round two, there could still be sperm left in the system that could be expelled with the pre-cum. Think of it like cake batter in a bowl. Not every drop makes it into the pan. There's usually batter stuck to the side of the bowl. Same thing with this system. Another thing, I know the pull-out method is really common and really popular, but it's not always the best method. Just because the person with a penis says that they're gonna pull out before they ejaculate, doesn't always mean it's gonna happen. Guys are not always perfect about it. They could forget, they could not care in the moment, or just have bad timing. If you don't wanna get pregnant, use condoms, get on birth control, and don't play the, please let me just put it in for a minute, I promise I won't come game. It's a dangerous road to start going down. So again, pregnancy from pre-cum by itself, no. But if the person with the penis has recently ejaculated and there's some sperm left in the system, it is possible that it could get carried out with pre-cum during that second round. In the next video, I'm gonna respond to some of your questions about this topic. So check it out. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. I've got a lot of content in production and I don't want you to miss out. So go ahead and click that subscribe button. And in the meantime, check out one of these other videos. And don't forget to send me your questions about sex to thomastalksabout@gmail.com.